Hello and welcome back to The Sideboard. I'm Ruben Bressler. I'm here with Leo Zausen, who has a unique, I think it's a red-black ramp deck. It's really unique. I was watching you earlier. It's just the most bizarre thing. One of your opponents actually, after you played, said, man, you really don't like creatures. Yeah. And that's basically the theme of the deck. Talk a little bit about your red-black control list here.
Right. I mean, it was kind of made towards a very heavily aggressive to mid-range meta, and then it kind of adapted through like bombs towards the end of the curve. But it's basically just like a red-black control deck with a ramp. I mean, it functions kind of similar to some like blue-black control list, except I think that Faithless Looting is excellent in the deck, and it works pretty well with some of the more flashback targets.
Right, and I noticed that you actually, every control deck needs not just ramp, but also needs card draw.
Right,
you have
yeah.
Faithless Looting, and you have M13 edition Sign and Blood.
Those are sort of
lifebloods of the deck.
Yeah, Sign and Blood is actually a last minute add. I usually had four Faithless Looting, but this card is it's great.
Yeah,
it's
and
really
you
good.
Actually have another card draw spell on the deck. You have a Staff of Nin.
Yeah, I have a Staff of Nin.
How's that been for you today?
It's been alright. The one time I used it, I pinged one more towards Restoration after a Slag Storm, but usually it comes out against some of the more aggressive times. But I mean, I think it's an amazing card, and it's going to see a lot of play in control decks post-rotation.
Yeah, and you have a ton of threats. You have multiple Titans, Grave, Inferno, and the sixth Titan, Wormcoil Engine.
Yeah,
in addition, you have Batterskull and the oft-maligned Sorin's Vengeance for your victory conditions.
Yeah, I mean, Wormcoil is pretty insane right now because, I mean, these guys just kind of enter the battlefield and just get eaten by Celestial Purges, but Wormcoil just sticks around for a while. O-Ring's the biggest threat towards Wormcoil, but they sometimes come out against that. Oh yeah, and Sorin's Vengeance is, I mean, it's 7 mana, you know, do 10 and gain 10.
Yeah, it's a 20-point life swing. That's nothing to sneeze at.
Yeah, not at all. So, I mean, it's... Yeah, I like it.
It
works sometimes.
And you, of course, have Slagstorm, Bonfire, Whip Flare, Black Sun Zenith as sweepers, as well as multiple elimination spells, Go for the Throat, a Devil's Play, a Pillar, a Galvanic Glass. You just got everything. And in addition, you've got an unblockable creature, basically, in Stenzia Bloodhall against Planeswalkers and players. Like, it seems like it's a really nice mix here.
Yeah, you'd be surprised how many people just, like, laugh when I play Stenzia Bloodhall. I mean,
they laugh, and then 3 turns later it
kills them. I mean, it does the job. I mean, it does, like, 4... It does 2 damage a turn, but, you know, you can get Planeswalkers with it. You can, but, yeah, Bonfire is obviously, you know, objectively a great card right now. Yeah, it's just about dealing with
the
creatures.
The deck just seems absolutely bonkers. And then the fun continues
The
sideboard. You've got a couple interesting choices here. The first one I'm going to highlight is Thundermaw Hellkite.
Yeah, that's...
Has that been a... What does that come in against?
It comes in against Esper. It comes in... Today I played it against round one, and I won against... I won my match. He treated for like 5, like a crazy amount, and I just Thundermaw and tapped him all in one.
Nice. And another one I want to target here is Despise. You decided to choose Despise.
Yeah.
Spell.
Yeah. Despise is good. It was between that, obviously, Duress, and also Appetite for Brains was considered. But I think Despise gets what I want to get. Just those high end creatures that just, and also Planeswalkers.
Now, to me, the most surprising choice in your sideboard is probably this Mindslaver.
Yeah.
Has that been very good for you?
I was anticipating a lot of mono block control coming into here. I haven't brought it in yet. But we'll see, you know. I'm a huge fan of the card, so maybe I'll get to play it. You know.
Well, you're doing pretty well.
Yeah.
What are your matchups like?
My matchups, I've been 2 Delve, where I won one, I lost one, and then I've beaten Naya Humans and a Esper midrange deck.
Cool. Well, the deck looks like a blast to play. It looks, I mean, if you like control decks, this is probably the deck for you. This is the controlliest control deck I've seen in Standard. And by far the control deck without blue that I've ever seen. It looks like so much fun, and we'll be hoping that you make top 8. Leo, thank you so much.
You.